In this video, I want to talk about the role of the right adductor, so the right inner thigh, in relation to lateral pelvic tilt. Now, when I first started trying to deal with my own lateral pelvic tilt many years ago, before I found postural restoration, everything I read was about one muscle being tight and pulling, or another being weak, or whatever it's going to be. It's always tight and strong, or loose or stretched out and weak. And sometimes that is slightly true, but it's not the cause of anything. That is the result of a position that you're stuck in. This is what I really want to emphasize to people. Muscles don't get tight or stretched out or overly strong just because. It happens because of a position that they are stuck in. Because when one side of the body is active, the other side of the body has to relax. That's how we walk. So if our weight, so here's the pelvis, and just imagine, right, my body's on top of the pelvis. Here's the right, here's the left. When I go onto my right foot, the muscles of the right side of the body, in order to stabilize that foot, have to tighten up because they're stabilizing the leg because your weight is over there. On the left side, those muscles are relaxing to allow your left leg to go through the air as you walk. And then when you shift your weight to the left side, so when you're on your left leg, the muscles on the left side should tighten up to stabilize your body, while the muscles on the right side relax and let your right leg go through the air. And remember, your torso is rotating at the same time, but it's the same principle. One side has to compress and stabilize, while the other side has to let go so it can move. Now, if you get stuck in the left AIC pattern, which the majority of us are at some point, that means your pelvis has oriented to the right. It just reflects, this left AIC name just reflects muscular activity that results in a pelvis oriented to the right. Now, you can watch other videos that I have made that explain why this happens, and it comes back to our larger right diaphragm. So if in breathing, you have the two diaphragms, the left and the right, not just one diaphragm, and the right one is so much bigger and larger and stronger that it rotates our spine to the right ever so slightly, 23,000 times a day for breathing, and we'd become right dominant. So the human body is just built to be right dominant. So if you get stuck with a pelvis to the right, like most people are, that means your body will reflect overactive tightness on the right side because you constantly are on that right leg. Even when you put your weight on the left leg, you will put your weight on the left leg, probably not all of it, but you will, at least some of it or most of it. But when you try to stabilize on that left side, you're doing it through compensation. Because, so here's the pelvis, right side, this should happen, left side, left side. That's what should happen, but that's not happening. It's right side, you go to the left, and the pelvis still stays oriented to the right. It never flips. So the muscles on the right side, because you never get that alternating pelvis position, the muscles on the right side never turn off. And so the right adductor is not the cause of the pelvic tilt. It could, it's a really stubborn muscle sometimes. It could keep you in that tilt, even with PRI exercises. Sometimes that right adductor is so tight that you can't really shift your pelvis properly in order to do the exercise, and you just don't feel it correctly. And sometimes that right adductor is really tight. Now, you could try to stretch it. So let me just show you. If this is the leg, here's your right leg, sitting in the acetabulum of the pelvis. When the pelvis orients to the right, that leg will go with it. So your leg would be facing out to the right, but you can't really walk like that. So the leg, actually my hand might work better. So let's say my fingertips are the front of the leg. The pelvis orients to the right, the leg orients to the right, but to stay straight, to walk straight, that's not a great position. So the leg internally rotates. And when the adductor goes from here, from the pelvis to my hand, when that leg comes in, see how these are coming closer together? Pelvis, leg. That's what tightens the adductor, but it doesn't cause it. Now that can hold you into the tilt. So how do you get that adductor to relax? You could try stretching, or we call it inhibiting, trying to turn it off. However, that's not always the greatest thing to do. It doesn't always work. What you may need to do is put a paper towel underneath your right arch, the right arch of your foot. So here's my foot. You have an arch, the medial arch, I can't even see it. Medial arch, lateral arch. We want the medial arch, where you're the arch that you see in your foot. Put a paper towel underneath that. Or actually, before you do that, figure out where you feel your weight on your feet. Take off your shoes, take off your socks, stand on the ground. If you feel your weight on the outside of your right foot, it probably means that your brain will not sense the arch. And if you can't sense your arch and thus the ground underneath it, you can't push to the left. So that's why sometimes the exercises don't work. If you can't get to the left, it means you're not turning off the right side overactivity, and thus it's hard to activate that left hamstring and get the hip shifted. If you can't feel the ground, your brain can't sense the ground. This happens all the time. Put a paper towel underneath the arch to bring the ground up to the arch. If you then sense that arch, it will turn off the overactive right muscles, including the adductor, and it will allow you to shift your hips better and do these PRI exercises, and that could be the key to changing a lot of things. That right arch, giving yourself a right arch, can make all the difference in the world. You could be doing exercise after exercise after exercise, and it just doesn't seem to be working. It's usually because you can't turn off the right side. And a lot of times, your brain has lost awareness of that right arch. And if it can't get the right arch to come down, so your foot's staying in a supinated position, it never truly pronates, you can't get to the left, which means you can't turn off the overactive right side, including the right adductor. So one of the best ways to turn off a right adductor that's holding you, didn't cause it, but it's holding you into an asymmetrical pelvis position and a tilt, is by using sensory information from the ground or the paper towel, giving your right arch, your brain, sensory information from the ground, and that can often relax the right side of your body. I've seen this happen over and over. The tests change immediately. People feel a difference immediately. They feel their weight shift to the left. They feel grounded on the left. And then they can do their exercises properly. It doesn't mean you need an orthotic. It could just be a one-time thing. But I highly recommend trying it. If you have a tight right adductor and stretching it is not working, and it probably won't work, give yourself a right arch by roll up a paper towel, put it underneath your right arch, feel it, and then see what happens.